Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So today's video is probably the best news we've had in a very long time for SCRCPY. And the good news is it's basically merged SCRCPY with SNDCPY. So we have audio forwarding and audio streaming by default in SCRCPY version 2.0. It's all enabled by default. So once you've set up SCRCPY version 2.0, audio streaming is enabled as long as you are above the correct Android version. So once you head over to the GitHub page and update to 2.0, you'll see here audio forwarding is on Android 11 or greater. So you can have a flick through here for the information. There's a few other really good changes here as well. Okay, so if you use this page quite often, probably for shortcuts and stuff and commands, it has changed a lot. All of the original commands now have been placed inside different menus. So if you scroll down to user documentation, you can see all of the different subcategories. So there's a couple of interesting ones to note here. So for video, you have these sections here. Definitely check out bitrate because it adjusts the quality. If you're not sure about using commands, I've got a video in the description showing you how to use that. I've also got a playlist full of SCRCPY guides, so definitely check that one out as well. The other thing I'm going to mention here is this. So there's now the option to change codecs. So you can use H.264, 265, and AV1. AV1's a bit of a hit and miss here. So just keep an eye on your device. It might work or may not work, but H.265 is definitely worth having a look at. As well as video options, there's plenty of other options in here, so you can flick through those in your own time. So if we go back up to the audio section here, this is the major change. So we've got Android 11 or higher, audio forwarding, audio streaming is by default. So once you connect your device to your computer, it'll play through your speakers, headphones, whatever you have connected, which is brilliant. It's been a long time coming. Older versions, you'll still need to use SNDCPY, which is okay, but there is a bit of a delay sometimes, which is annoying. There's a new command here as well. If you don't want audio forwarding, that's the command to run. Again, codecs, and then you can list encoders, change bit rates, etc. All of this stuff is done using commands. So if you don't know how to use commands, again, check out the guide in the description. Another thing I will mention is to check out the option to create batch files. So batch files allow you to create a SCRCPY shortcut. So I'll just go to mine here. Just in my SCRCPY folder, I have the shortcut here. So we'll just open it. So these are the ones I'm using. Each one of these enables a different feature. So definitely check out creating this batch file. It'll save you a hell of a lot of time, especially if you want to run a lot of different commands and change encoders for opening SCRCPY. Anyway, I think that wraps this guide up. Definitely upgrade to 2.0 if you can. I haven't found any bugs or any issues with it. Anyway, that's it for this guide. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.